Welcome to Refashion Your Life.
Okay, so I put out my 80-pound purpose and with my before and after picture, and I appreciate all of the wonderful comments people have made, but the number one question that I have been asked, and I'm still asked all the time, is what do you eat? So I want to talk to you about my journey with food. Now, I told you I didn't start out with food. I started out with just starting to move. But soon after I did that, I realized I needed to make a change. And the first change I had decided was sugar. So that was really kind of easy for me. That was like, I know, easier than some of the other things. And I loved it because it was a challenge and I could do it. So I just started cutting out desserts and just making sure that things that I ate just didn't have a lot of sugar in them, and just like the baby steps. So then the next thing I decided was bread. Okay, now hold on, bread. Let me tell you, warm, hot bread drenched in butter and cinnamon and sugar or jelly. Okay, totally my favorite. That was the hardest thing for me to do because I realized I was eating so much bread. And so that was my treat. I'd rather choose bread over even chocolate. I know, relax. But it was, bread is my weakness. But I did it. I said, okay, I'm gonna cut this out. I'm gonna have bread once a week. And I did it. And these were just little baby steps that I did. Well, then I started, you know, exercising and doing things and realizing I needed to change my diet even more because I needed more fruits and vegetables, like the same old stuff that you hear all the time. But here's my secret. I hate salad. Hate it. I don't want to eat a salad every day or every other day. I do not like salad. It is not my thing. So I did not lose weight eating a salad. To me, people that go, I'm on a diet, I'm going to eat a salad. I think that's what pushed me away from salad. I don't want to eat it. Don't have me one. So I was like, well, what am I going to do? I need to eat fruits and vegetables and things. So I did join Weight Watchers. I joined Weight Watchers for 1 week, and I'll tell you why. I joined Weight Watchers for the purpose of learning about food. Everybody else was joining Weight Watchers to have this support group, but I had a support group outside of that. But I felt like they could teach me a little bit more about food. So I joined Weight Watchers and I went to every meeting, everything I could in that 1 week period because it was like the free week. And I learned so much. I learned so much, but the most profound thing that was said to me there was a lady got up to do her presentation and she said, your body is your vehicle to get around in this life. You don't take your actual car to the gas station and stand there at the fuel pump and just fuel and fuel and fuel and fuel and fuel it up until you are tired of it. You know when it's full, the thing clicks off and you're done. Well, why would you go into your kitchen and fuel and fuel and fuel and fuel your body when you only need so much fuel, but you're overflowing it? And where's that spilling out? It's not like your car is going to spill out on the ground. It's going to spill out all over your body because you only need so much fuel. And that was like the biggest thing I learned from Weight Watchers. So anyways, I did that for a week and I realized my body was really efficient. And I didn't really realize that. So I needed to learn about my body, what my body needed, what it was out of balance in, what it lacked, and just pull at different things. So I did that. And everybody's journey is going to be different, okay? But the biggest thing I had to deal with, which everybody has to deal with, are your emotional triggers. Because I think 90% of people are emotional eaters. So what are your emotional triggers, okay? Recognize when they kick in. The second thing I needed to do was, okay, so at 3 o'clock, when I had that urge to just, I need to eat something, I needed to allow myself to go stuff my face. So I did, but I started to stuff my face with carrots and grapefruit and my favorite thing in the entire world, almonds. So at 3 o'clock, when I felt like I just needed to stuff my face, I needed to eat, I did. I let myself eat as much as I wanted of that kind of food. And that changed me because your body responds differently when you eat food like that. When you eat something out of a box or something that has a lot of sugars or processed food, it triggers in your body on a cellular level that you want to eat more of it. And that's why you keep eating more, because it suppresses that feeling that your body has met the lack that it's searching for. But when you feed it good food, your body absorbs that immediately and that craving is gone. So that's one thing I had to learn about my body. So stuff your face when you feel like it, but pick up the right things when you're doing it. And then the other thing that really hit home for me was a saying that said, what you eat in private, you wear in public. And I thought, that's right, when I'm home and I got the cookies hidden up here, you know, I'm gonna eat that, but it's gonna show to everybody. They might not know I ate those cookies, but they're gonna know I ate something, because obviously I'm not changing. So then, my next journey as I'm grabbing at all these things and learning about food is I just learned more what I like to eat, what I enjoy to eat, and that I was eating about 4 times what I needed. And it's amazing how much I don't eat now compared to what I ate then, but I eat more often. So going with that being said, you have to eat more to lose more if you're eating the right foods. So people are always like, if I go on a diet, I'm not going to be able to eat. That is not true. If you just change your habits, not a diet, change your habits, you can eat as much as you want, when you want. I eat 6 meals a day, and I have oodles of calories that I don't even count anymore. And I stay down at my size, but I'm very active. I'm at the gym. That's the one thing I wanted to go to. This is a saying that really affected me too. You lose weight in the kitchen, you get fit at the gym. And that was hit home for me, because how many times when I go to the gym, I worked out my hour today, I can splurge, I can eat this. That is not true. You lose weight in the kitchen, you get fit at the gym. So I hope I have given you some of my little nuggets that helped me. Everybody's food journey is different, but you can do it. And you know what? It's fun. It's a challenge. Because when you start to incorporate these things, it's fun. You can still go to restaurants and not order a salad. I do not order a salad when I go to a restaurant. I search for the things with vitamin A, vitamin E, and I learned what those things were. So go on your journey and learn them. Sweet potatoes, and I do like my iron from a little bit of meat. You know, love broccolis. I love these things that I can pull in. So I know you can do it, no excuses. So I wanna leave you with a few of my inspirational things, things that made me laugh about food, things that inspired me to understand food and not fear food. And food is fun for me now, because I love to create these things with real food, like real, like, you know, grown from the earth. You know, that thing that we call organic, but our grandparents called just regular food. I think that's so funny. So anyways, I hope that inspired you. I hope that answers some of your questions, and enjoy your journey.